inviting me to talk to your distinguished audience. I'll start talking today about the planning structure of Qatar for the future. The Qatar National Vision 2030 has identified five major challenges that you can see here. And it is very important to tackle all these challenges. The development path of Qatar is setting out these challenges, which is, I think, common in the GCC countries. Here is the Qatar National Vision, interrelated four pillars. As you can see, the institutional development and modernization is a cross-cutting dimension, and we consider it extremely important dimension. Without a strong institutions in any country, the vision, the ambitious vision, will not be sustained. The management, of course, has to secure optimum utilization of the resources that we have, and we know it's depleting. The Qatar National Vision is the overall umbrella of the planning process in Qatar. We have the development, the National Development Strategy, which is a six years National Development Strategy, and then we review the strategy itself and make sure that we get a stack of what we achieved and what we have, and understanding the gaps and overlapping in the National Development Strategy based on the implementation itself. Here's the planning process, which you can see that it is a two-way process, bottom-up and top-down process. The framework itself strives to ensure alignment with the Qatar National Vision 2030 down to the ministries and agencies which implement the initiatives and programs of the National Development Strategy. The National Development Strategy 2011-2030 is the first Qatar National Strategy, and we have started implemented since 2011, and we are almost achieving most of the goals and objectives of this strategy. The, as you can see, again, that it is a comprehensive strategy, not only focusing on the economy, as we can see from different strategies. For each sector of the strategy, we have set out clear outcomes and time-bound targeted targets to achieve through various reforms, programs, and initiatives. And then we have the midterm review, which provide, as I said, a very clear analysis of the problems that we face when we implement the strategy, and we also analyze the gaps and overlapping in the strategy. And it gives us a very good opportunity, actually, to take stock of the implementation achievements. The NDS, as you can see here, is built around the framework that has three mutually supporting pillars, as you can see. And the pillars assume creation of a union health genuine wealth, economic management and efficiency and economic innovation and diversification. Genuine wealth takes in account all of sources of capital, human and institutional, and environmental as well as fixed assets, land and mineral and financial wealth. As you can see, Qatar's saving has been very high over the last 15 years, and it is by all standards a very high one, but we expect this to continue, and it is by all standards a very high saving. Qatar has accumulated, as a result of that, a significant stock of assets, both in Qatar and outside. And saving have benefited, as you can see, from the very high oil prices over the last few years. The goals of the economic management here for achieving fiscal sustainability, actually many of these initiatives are targeted to toward promoting efficiency, reducing economic volatility, and achieving sustainable fiscal finance. These same reforms will also help better insulate the economy from fluctuating of the oil prices. And I think we have done quite well in this regard, taking in account the last year's fluctuation in the oil price. The non-hydrocarbon sector output share is, as you can see, in the last few years has been successfully catching up with the very high oil prices, and it is representing now about 50% of the total GDP, which I think is a very good performance, and it is actually growing on double digit over the last few years, and we expect it to be continuing that way, taking into account the very heavy investment in the infrastructure and the diversifying the economy. And it is clearly driven mainly by heavy investment and the rapid expanding of the population. And we are trying to isolate that again from the oil revenues in order to make sure that it is a sustained growth of the of this sector. This is the sector, the private sector contribution to aggregate activities. As you can see, it is still a small portion, but if we consider the public sector contribution traditionally in the economy and the oil price increases and the increase of the GDP itself, I think the private sector has been doing quite a good job over the last few years, and an important goal of the National Development Strategy is to enlarge the space for private sector contribution into the economy, and I think that we will see a much better performance in the future, again taking into account the investing heavily in the infrastructure and encouraging private sector to take part of the development of the country. Here is some point about the knowledge economy indicators. Here is the Qatar ranking in different publications, and we found that Qatar is seeking to a diversified knowledge economy which depend critically on providing the right economic incentives regime, innovation, education, and the ICT. According to the World Bank global ranking of the countries, these four dimensions of the knowledge economy, Qatar is well positioned in comparison to the region, and it has many steps to take in order to catch up with the global ranking. Again, this is about the knowledge economy. It is very important for Qatar to place itself in considerable emphasis in producing graduates which are capable of working in a knowledge economy, taking into account the small portion of the labor force of the Qatari graduates. And there are ongoing reform of the National University to realign the program toward these most required specialties. And I think we have reached a good status where the specialties are more and more focusing on the knowledge-based economy needs and requirements. And therefore, the Qatar has created the Education City, and through the Education City, we have invited very well-known universities, focusing again on the knowledge-based specialties and these specialties include policy, social science, businesses, innovation, design, and cultural and heritage. And we have seen Qatari students taking increasingly studying in these universities and specializing in these knowledge-based related studies. And we have also seen a good rate of growth in terms of Qatar's working on the private sector and the mixed sector, which is a private public mixed sector. We have seen a very steady increase in these sectors, which we think it is extremely important to structure the Qatari labor force in these sectors. Traditionally, nationals sought employment in the public sector and because they thought it is more stable and more secure, but we found that it is unsustainable, and that's why we encourage them through a privatization, Qatarization process and programs, and encouraging them to participate in the private sector. And we also noticed that the increase is not only in numbers, but also in the quality of people are more and more going to the private sector in terms of higher skilled occupation. And also it is linked to the privatization policy. For the non-Qatari labor force, unfortunately, we haven't been able to succeed in transforming this sector into a more skilled labor. We have still very high ratio of unskilled and semi-skilled laborers, which can be explained by the heavy focus on the infrastructure and construction phase of of our development plan. And we think that will be changed soon when the investment is shifted into more sophisticated and advanced knowledge economy, as I said before, when the infrastructure is set and the capacity of the economy is increased. (Clears throat) think I have finished my time, but I will conclude by this 4 points. The Qatar National Vision, as I said, foresees progressive transformation to a diversified competition economy with increased private sector management. And we have started seeing this in reality. Education, skill, labor force, research, development are key to this aspiration. And we have, as I said, started this by inviting specialized universities and colleges. The National Development Strategy 2011-2016 initiatives aiming to create an educated and capable and motivated workforce. Significant focus is on improving the education and training outcomes. We have, for this reason, created a couple of specialized colleges for vocational training and education. The mid-term review has provided us with a very valuable analysis, and it was all done by the World Bank in order to make sure it is unbiased and it provides us with the best practices of the world. The economic diversification, we have a strong belief that it is the future of Qatar. We have no way to go but to diversify our economy, and the diversification requires a multi-dimension transformation in terms of institutions, skills, incentives, and Qatar planning and policy initiatives responding to these challenges very clearly. Thank you very much.